Superstar swimmer Siobhan Haughey is now Hong Kong's most decorated Olympic athlete of all time. For more, let's head to Tokyo. Paul, she's done it. Siobhan has clinched the silver medal in the 100 metres freestyle final. You were at the Aquatic Centre. What was it like? Can you take me through it?
Yeah, momentous occasion. She's given us another historic moment, this girl. She's incredible. She was always in touch in the race. She started well. She had one of the quickest reaction times out the blocks. And, you know, it's all, obviously, it's about pacing on the first 50. And then in the second 50, she really came through. And she was saying that it was total heads down, backs to the wall, just going as fast as she could right to the end. And of course, she set another Asian record. You know, she couldn't really do much better. Every swim so far in Tokyo, she's just improved and improved and improved, and she did it again.
And she looked so happy after she touched the wall and saw her result. You got to speak to her after the race. What did she have to say?
She's thrilled. It's all still a dream to her. She's maintained, whenever I've managed to grab a word within the last few days, that she never expected this. You know, her attitude is great. She come into this just saying, look, I'm here to have fun and soak up the atmosphere and enjoy and try and go my fastest that I can. There's no pressure. And, you know, if I'm winning medals along the way, then that's just a bonus. Really refreshing attitude from her. I'm sure she's playing it down. She can't have come here without the expectation of going for the medal. She knew the position she was in. She knew how good she is. Her coaches, her team around her certainly knew. But she seems very confident, very free and easy. There's no nerves. She's not even remotely uptight about anything that's happening in the pool. She maintains that she's just here to have fun, and she's managed to land two silver Olympics medals in the course of having that fun with her friends out here at the Games. So yeah, truly, truly momentous. She's become, of course, Hong Kong's greatest Olympian, most decorated Olympian. Excellent for her.
Do you think that's, hit her yet when you spoke to her? She's won two silvers now, one in the 100, one in the 200 metres freestyle. Does she realise the weight of what she has done?
I sense not, because she's so relaxed. I think maybe it will start to dawn on her in the next few days, especially when she, you know, once she turns on her Instagram and takes a look at all the incredible support she's been getting from across Hong Kong, all corners of Hong Kong. I think it'll really start to hit her. I didn't mention that to her. Was she ready for how much of a superstar she's about to become back home? And she said that she's pleased to be this side of it and looking at it from afar for now, so she can try to get her head around it. No, I don't think it's really sunk in yet. Obviously, it was only a few hours ago. But yeah. It's massive for her. It's massive for the city, but it's huge for her.
And she's back in the pool tonight with the 50 meter heats. What can she do there? Do you think she's a medal contender at all in this event?
She is. She's so laid back that I think she'll be approaching tonight like she's having a swim down in Victoria Park swim and bath with her friends. She seems to have no pressure at all. She doesn't feel any pressure. She said, actually, that once she landed that first silver, that took all the pressure on it off of her, even for today. So two silvers, she's really not under any stress going into this 50 meters tonight. She'll be there to have fun. You know, she was leading over the 50 meters today, leading or just narrowly second, but she's as good a sprinter as anyone in that field. So it wouldn't surprise me if she was able to go triple Olympic medalist. I can't believe I'm saying it. But she concedes that the 200 is her pet event, the 100 a little bit less, she won silver, and the 50 a little bit less again. So we'll see, but no pressure on her at this point. She's already done us so proud.
So proud, and fingers crossed for tonight, and then hopefully she can make it all the way into the finals of the 50. But there was a bit of heartbreak today for Hong Kong athletes. The badminton duo, they lost to Japan so close to bronze.
Yeah, it was an incredible match. Johnny was down there and he was really very excited about how it was going down there, but I don't blame him. It seemed like it was really back and forth. It was a little bit with my hands full. I didn't actually manage to get to see the game, but he's told me all about it and I've read about it. It was a real back and forth encounter, a thriller. Of course, they were going for the bronze medal, which would have been, again, beyond anyone's expectations that the Hong Kong mixed doubles duo could land that. They were narrowly beaten. Well, they were beaten in two sets, but it was very tight. It was very tight. They gave everything they had, Tang. And so I think I mentioned to you yesterday that they were trying to do it for their departing coach, and they really did leave it all out there today. In the end, the Japanese pair, Watanabe and Higashino, they were just a little bit too strong for them, but there was no shame in that performance this morning. They really gave it everything they had.
And I'm sure their coach, you know, despite the result, is super proud of how they've done, as is Hong Kong. Paul, thank you very much for joining me, and I'll catch you again tomorrow.
Thanks.